Hello, and welcome back or to the channel. Many thanks to those who have subscribed or those who just visit the channel and check out the videos and the shorts. Today we're on a road trip from Redruth to Hayle, and rather than take the easy route down the A30, we're going to go via a bunch of villages and towns to give you an idea of what it's like to travel through Cornwall. So buckle up and enjoy the ride. Right, here we are, parked up in Hayle Town Centre. Truck is parked along the high street. That way you don't have to pay for parking. You have to be careful where you park along this street, because some parts of it you can park all day for free, but other parts it's limited to about half an hour. So the further you come down the high street, the more likely it's going to be free. I was going to park in the car park across the road there. I don't know if you can see where that building is, but it looks pretty jammed. I had planned to come out earlier today, but it was quite misty this morning, so I thought I'd leave it. And wait for the sun to break through. So here we go. Some lovely churches here. Look at that building, amazing. This area is a protected wildlife reserve. You get hundreds of birds landing here. I was down here the other day and there was just dozens and dozens of Canadian geese. I was hoping we'd see that today, but unfortunately can't see any. Actually a swimming pool here, which is where you got the Lido there, so you can read that. So it's an outdoor swimming pool. Just cut across here and show you this sign. If you can read that, it's King George the Fifth Memorial Walk Subtropical Gardens. And I'll take you for a walk around the gardens. This estuary is fed by the ocean, which I'll take you up to that. All these new builds along this area here, overlooking the harbour area, and I think they start at about £800,000 for an apartment overlooking the Estuary Harbour area. And some of them are over £1 million. Absolutely crazy. Because you can find properties in Cornwall with acres of land for that kind of money. Be on in a detached house, surrounded by your own countryside, possible woodlands and everything. But instead you're just overlooking this estuary there. Would you pay £1 million for one of these? Don't think I would. I mean, it's stunning views, but when the tide's out, it's essentially just mud. Right, back there is where the tropical gardens are. And I'll take you back there after we've been up here for a bit of a walk. There's all sorts of buildings going up along this area. So you pay all that money for these apartments and all you get is one car parking space. Mad. But there you go. I suppose it's just a holiday home for lots of people. For the wealthy, maybe. Park your Land Rover or whatever there and look out your window and watch all the diggers at play. This would be quite interesting to look back in a few years when this is all finished. This is what it looked like in October 2023. Look at this crane up here. How long does it take for the guy who's controlling that to actually climb all those stairs? That's a ladder, vertical ladder, to get all the way up to the top of there. Look at this. This is, you think it was in Spain in the 1970s when they started building all the hotels for the British tourists to come and stay. Well, this is incredible, really, though. All this concrete, that's eco-friendly, I guess. See that church over there, all that area in front, I'm not sure if you can make out, there's a buggy going along there. That's actually a golf course. So what a lovely location to play golf. Not that I play golf, but if one does, really nice place to go. Cool looking building. Do you like the grey with the wood? Not sure what wood that would be, maybe birch. Right now, you wouldn't think it, but if you cut down through here, and you wouldn't know unless you lived here. Here we are. This used to be free parking here. I'm not sure if it is anymore. That's the guys inflating their paddle boards before they go out. And this, where this blue van is here, this is where we normally park up when we bring our paddle boards down. And then you got to carry them down the sand dunes. Quite breezy here at the moment, so hopefully the audio isn't too bad. It's see that house across the bay there, that was up for sale not long ago. I can't remember how much it was. Right, let's take a walk along the sand dune bit. We get to the top of this hilly bit and give you a panoramic view of Hayle Estuary. I can work out how to get through there. So now this could be a pathway, I think. Yep. A little bit overgrown, but oh yeah, look, that leads up to the end of the car park. Keeps you fit doing all this. Not that I'm particularly fit, but probably fitter than I might otherwise have been. Right, here we go. Looks like a well-trodden path with all the footprints. Oh, this is quite an angle. Right with you, going back to the crane. Tide is actually in at the moment. When it's out, it goes beyond those poles out in the ocean to make them out. And you can walk up to the right and keep walking all the way up to Godrevy, where the Godrevy Lighthouse is. And if you want to see more about the Godrevy Lighthouse, I've got a video on visiting that as well. And that's called Red Roof to Godrevy Road Trip. Do a mix of videos, some are just videos of locations we've been to, and others are actual the road trip as well. The sea looks really calm today, barely any waves at all. That's St. Ives in the distance. Carbis Bay to the left, a little bit further up. But this beach here, when the tide's out, all the way back to Godrevy, that's about three to four miles long. So massive a beach to mess around on. Colourless water, it's like blues, greens, turquoise, nice and clear, as most Cornish waters are. Virtually no rocks or stones under the water, so you can swim, paddleboard, surf, fall off and not worry about rocks underneath. Right, I'll cut it there and get back to where the gardens are. Right, here we are at the beginning of the Memorial Garden Walk. Get off the road so I don't get run over. I'll pick myself up a Magnum mint ice cream. I'll enjoy that while we're looking at the gardens. Walk across this car park bit here, which is where I'd hope to park. There is actually some spaces now. I don't think there was when I arrived there. Lestrey, as I say, the other day this was absolutely jammed in this area, hundreds of birds. But we wander down, and the gardens are on the left hand side, the estuary on the right. The crunchy noises will be me eating the ice cream. Lots of tropical plants here. The climate is so mild in Cornwall most of the time that all sorts of plants grow here. There's benches every few yards along this area. And quite often just come down here and walk around the gardens, bring a flask of tea, sit on the bench and enjoy the scenery. No end of different types of palms in Cornwall. Certain times of year, all these lights are lit up. Lovely walk. Yep.
bird down here. Hello, matey. Now, just a little bit further along here, there's a netted off raised pond. And you might think, ooh, there might be one or two fish in there. But you might be a bit surprised. What a size of some of the fish in here. If we can get round to a certain light and actually see them. Some quite large fish in here. They must be almost a foot and a half long, 50, 60 centimetres. Oh, look at this silver one. That's huge. You can make that out. And koi carp. Quite expensive to buy in the UK, which is why this is netted off to stop people stealing them. Obviously not scared of humans because they probably think it's the people who come along to feed them. I didn't think this was deep enough to sustain these kind of fish, but obviously it does. Well, there you go. There we go, so don't steal from our pond. Nice little flower sculpture. Back out into the daylight. Imagine living in these homes along here. Amazing. Must cost a fortune. Little hidden bit in here, let's have a look down here. Another netted off area. Don't think there's any fish in this one. Oh, there are some goldfish. Much smaller though. You say got some plants to feed off. It's a bird feeder. Let's bring some seed and fish food next time, I think. Looks like a whole load of Canadian geese up there. You can probably hear them. All sculptory bits. Now this looks incredible. This is obviously must have been lock gates, I'm guessing, back in the day. Huge, these must be 15 feet high at least. Got a chain on that, incredible. Well, that's almost the end of the gardens. It goes a little bit further down. And then to where the white vans are. You can see the hundreds and hundreds of birds that are sitting on the marshlands. Way back to where the Hayle estuary is, and that church we walked past when we first arrived. It's supposed to be clear skies and sunshine from 10 o'clock this morning, but the sun didn't come out until about 12:30, 1 o'clock. And now it's clouded over again. Well, there you go. Red roof to Hayle. Hope you enjoyed the trip.
and the views of the estuary and the birds and the gardens. We'll see you again sometime for another road trip in Cornwall.